Hi viewers, today I am going to provide the information about the starter motor. You know, the starter motor actually the second important component in electrical system of the vehicle and machines. So first I show you visually all the components of the starter motor, then we go to the classrooms, and there I will tell you in details the works of each components of the starter motor, how we test it, how we troubleshoot each and everything. So please, I hope you will like this video, and you must share to your friends and also subscribe my channels. This is a starter motor. This is the second most important component of the electrical system of vehicle and machines, and now I will open it, dismantle it, and show you the different parts of this starters. So let's come. So this one is the this is starter, which I just dismantled for you people to show you the different part of the starters. So this one is the backside holders, backside holding. Here you can see this is a bearing. This one is the bearing, and the bearings holding the backside of this rotors. Here you fix it on these sides, and this is a rotor, and this one you can see this is a armature of the rotors, and this is a collector. Here's collector, and you can say this is a freewheeling clutch, freewheeling clutch, and this one is the actuating levers, actuated lever. So this, and this one is the magnetic switch. This is a magnetic switch. Okay, and these are the brushes. You can see these are the brushes, and inside of this you can see here is this is the exciter windings. These are the exciter windings. We are in lecture rooms, so today we are learning, we are going to learn about the starter motor. So what is a starter motor, how it works, and what are the components? So the starter motor is the second most important component of the electrical system of vehicle and machines. So what is a starter motor? The combustion engines need to start it by means of a special device, because they are not able to be start themselves. Starter convert the electrical energy stored in the battery into mechanical energy. The starter can only generate its power when a battery with appropriate capacity is available. What are the duty of the starter before starting the engine? To accelerate combustion engine to start speed with lowest possible consumption current. Second, to establish the gear connection between starter and the combustion engine. Number three, to maintain these connections. Number three, to switch on the starter current. Now, after the engine starting, to return the starter pinion to its initial positions. Number two, to switch off the starter current. Now, these are the parts of the starter motor. Number one, this one is a magnetic switch, and this one is the armature of the magnetic switch, and this one is the actuating lever and this one is the freewheeling clutch, and number five, this one is the spring resetting, is also called resetting spring, and number six is the brushes of this motor. Number seven is the exciting windings, and number eight is armature of this rotor, and number nine is the collectors. These are the main parts of the stator motor. Now we move to how the stator motor works. So first of all, the ignition switch in the start positions. With the ignition switch is start position, current flow from the battery through the holding winding and the pickup windings. The armature magnetically picked up and forces the pinion with actuating lever to engage with the ring gears. Mean when this switch is on, the current flow from this battery is entered, and this one is the pickup winding and this one is the holding windings, and here's the magnetically this armatures, what it is, this armature magnetically through this actuating lever pull engage this the freewheeling to the this rings. This actually is a engine gears. Now pinion meshes with the ring gears. So when the pinion meshes with the flywheels, and this now you can see in this figures that this pinion is meshes with the engine gears, and magnetic switch is closed, and pinion is engaged with this gears, and this magnetic switch is closed. So what happened? So under the current, a strong current flow from the battery directly into exciting winding and armature windings, but not into the pickup windings. This causes the armature to rotate with a high speed and drive the pinion, which in turn drives the ring gears with the speed of 200 to 3 rpm. Mean this, when this switch is closed, magnet switch is closed, current flow from this battery is entered the this exciting windings and armature windings, and due to this current, this rotor rotates, and this force the this freewheeling clutch to drive this engine with RPM 200 to 300. But current is not flowing to this pickup windings. It only flow to this one. Now engine is running. Once the engine is running and drives the pinion via ring gears, the freewheeling clutch will open and prevent the armature from being driven by the engines. When engine start running, at this flywheel clutch become open. So when this become open, it become free, and only with engine moving only this freewheeling clutch, and this freewheeling clutch is prevent this armature to moving with the engine. So ignition switch release, when we release the ignition switch, what happen? When release the ignition switch, it will return from the position start to on and interrupt the stator current circuit. Current will now start from battery through the contact plate in the pickup winding and holding windings. Since both coils generate opposed magnetic field, the magnetic field will collapse and resetting the spring and take the armature back to its initial positions. So what happened? When we release the switch from start position to go on positions. So this current is stopped, but this magnetic switch is still on. So it current come from battery to through and come this pickup windings and holding windings, and here both windings is create the magnetic field which opposing the each other forces, and due to this opposing magnetic force which is generate here, it resetting the this spring, and this resetting spring is armature come back. Then this armature come back, so this actuating lever is also go back in original position and the freewheeling clutch go back. So how we troubleshoot if there is a problem in the what type of problems occurs in the starter motor and how we can troubleshoot that problems. So first of all, if the starter rotate too slowly, and if the starter rotate too slowly, so what will we do it? Either the brushes partly worn off, the brushes will be maybe worn out, or part of the exciter or part of the armature winding is shorted. In some cases, oxidized contact, electric contacts or solid ground connection causes extremely high voltage losses in overall starter system are the causes problems. So sometimes what happens, there is a between the contacts are loose and their high power high voltage is losses and machine not start. Second, if the starter only emit the clicking sounds, sometimes it's not state only there sounds coming click click. So what happened that time either the magnetic switch is defect to dismantle and clean it. The main contacts of the magnetic switch are worn off, scrape off carefully with foil and clean it. The starter motor is defective, remove the armature and clean it. Third one is a problem frequently which is coming, a jammed return mechanism is reason for starter failures. These are the problems and how we can troubleshoot. So now test, how we test the starter motor? We must dismantle from the engines, and then we, as you can see in the figures how we can test it. So first of all, connect a jumper lead between the starter terminal and the battery plus in this starter terminal and to the positive battery of the terminal. Secondly, connect the jumper cable instantly between the starter housing and the battery minus. So this is a housing to any of the this starter motor and to the minus. If the motor does not start, the starter is defective, repair or replace it. So this is the brief discussion about the starter, what is starter, how it work and how we troubleshoot. And so I hope you will like this video. Please don't forget to share this video to your friends and also subscribe my channels. I am